Hello everyone. Today in this video, I'm going to discuss poem A Good Play from your course book. A good play is a poem which is taken from the book A Child's Garden of Verses. A Child's Garden of Verses is a collection of poetry for children by the Scottish author Robert Louis Stevenson. This book contains 65 poems. Before talking about this poem, I would like to ask you that do you play with household things, imagining it to be super gadgets and enjoyed a lot while playing? I am sure many of you have done this, wearing your mother's sari and pretending to be like your mother or teacher. Or you must have taken chairs, tables or baskets, imagining it to be your bike or car and rode on it and enjoyed every moment of it. Children, it is not necessary that you can only enjoy playing by having costly kitchen sets or robotic cars and bikes. You can also enjoy by simply pretending or imagining things at your home as your super gadgets. This is what the poem is all about. In this poem, A Good Play, the poet R.L. Stevenson tries to present his childhood memories and explains how contented he was with simple things in life. The poet uses words such as stairs, chairs, pillows, nails, and pails to present the simple things that they had at home to play with without wanting for any other costly toys. He says that his brother Tom and he would build ships with the furniture in the house and played with it until it was time for tea in the evening. The poet presents a life of satisfaction, contentment, and happiness with simple things in life. The poet is simply remembering his childhood days when he did not have any care for material things in life. So before explaining you the stanzas, I would like to recite the poem. You may follow me. We built a ship upon the stairs, all made of the back bedroom chairs, and filled it full of sofa pillows to go a sailing on the billows. We took a saw and several nails and water in the nursery pails. And Tom said, "Let us also take an apple and a slice of cake," which was enough for Tom and me to go a sailing on till tea. We sailed along for days and days and had the very best of plays. But Tom fell out and hurt his knee, so there was no one left but me. Children, in first stanza, the poet is saying that they built ship upon the stairs with the bedroom chairs, back bedroom chairs. Children, back bedroom chairs are the chairs which has long back for support and it is very comfortable. And when they joined two chairs and pretended They joined the two chairs and pretended it to be ship and enjoyed sailing on the imaginary sea and sailed along the waves. Billows are the waves of sea. The children, the poet used to join the two chairs and make it as a shape of a of ship and they used to fill it with pillows. Here in first stanza, we did not know about Tom. Poet is just saying we. In second stanza, poet is using the name of things that they used to carry with them on this imaginative journey with ship. They used to carry saw, nails, nursery pails. Pails are the buckets, the small buckets used to fill liquid like water. They used to carry saw, nails, nursery pails, apples and cake. They took apple and cake so that they don't feel hungry till the tea time in the evening. And in second stanza only we came to know about Tom, which we think might be his brother. In the third stanza, poet is saying that they used to play like this for many days and enjoy a lot. The poet is describing this play as the best play because they both were enjoying playing this. But then something happened and poet could not enjoy this game more. What happened? His brother Tom fell down from the stairs and got hurt on his knee. And so they cannot play this game any more. I hope you all have understood the poem. I will recite the poem once more and you all can follow me. We built a ship upon the stairs, all made of the back bedroom chairs, and filled it full of sofa pillows to go a sailing on the billows. We took a saw and several nails and water in the nursery pails. And Tom said, let us also take an apple and a slice of cake, which was enough for Tom and me to go a sailing on till tea. We sailed along for days and days and had the very best of plays. But Tom fell out and hurt his knee, so there was no one left but me. I hope you all have understood the poem. Now you learn the poem very well and make videos and send it to your class teachers. Your assignments will be available in the parent portal. You can copy down your assignments in the course copies. Thank you.